What's up, builders? So today I want to go over three new updates that have happened inside of Voiceflow. And for those of you that are not aware, Voiceflow is an AI agent building platform for both chat and voice that I use frequently. And it looks like the roadmap has been cooking of late. So I just want to go through a few of these announcements. I can drag the Discord announcement in here just to kind of show you. Agents can now automatically use buttons, cards, and carousels. Great way to add visuals and more interactive layer to your agents. So I'm going to show you an example of this working. And let's just kind of jump into this here. So this is a very basic agent that I threw together just to show a demo off of the site, which is a dental tool. Nothing really crazy going on. There's only three, really main nodes here: a greeting, the agent, and then the calendly block to book a schedule. It's a very basic agent. If you hit start here, you'll notice this brand new window. I need to move my head here. Let me see if I can do this. All right, let's do that. So you'll notice that we've got new logging here in the canvas, which I am a huge fan of, and this actually reminds me a little bit of BotPress when you execute a workflow and you get the logs show up here in the bottom. If you click on any of this, you actually get the JSON object payload that's being passed to Voiceflow Trace. And those of you that have been using the transcripts API to kind of diagnose what's going on and what traces are firing, this is way, way easier and faster. We can also use what is happening here to really fine tune the agent and understanding what is going on a little bit under the hood of these Voiceflow builds to start doing some really cool things. So that's the first thing. Very, very quick, easy. It's nice. You get this by clicking either the run button up here in the top right, or by clicking this play button on start. So if I go through here, let's go and look at this dynamic buttons, cards, and carousel. So if I click on any of these, there's an LLM description that pops open similar to the knowledge base, which, you know, I usually modify in most of my agent builds, because most of the time I want to trigger the knowledge base pretty much always and not use general LLM knowledge depending on the application. But for buttons, cards, and carousels, you can see that Voiceflow has pre-populated a description, display a UI picker when the user needs to select one option from a predefined list, and then it's got up to five options. You can change this to whatever you want, but it's probably good practice just to kind of use what Voiceflow has put out here in the beginning just to get an idea to see how this particular tool works. For cards, summarizes the assistant's response in a visual card with title, image, description, optional action button. And then carousel is, of course, multiple cards that you can click through. So to see this in action, let's go back here. Welcome to interview, blah, 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 blah. So if I say, question list up here. Here we go. Show me clinical studies by time period. It's going to go into this agent. And you can see this is dynamic buttons coming through. Foundational studies, 90s, 2000s, development era, modern research, latest publications. And if I click on one of these, just do modern research, this is actually going to generate a dynamic carousel off of the dynamic button selection, which is pretty slick. Now, I just started messing around with this yesterday, so this is not optimized by any stretch of the imagination, but I just wanted to showcase the ability to do this inside of the canvas now. And it does take a little bit of time as it's generating this carousel from scratch. So depending on what's going on and what you have in here, but you can see, you can click through and it has generated a carousel. Now these images Obviously, like I said, are not optimized, and you certainly would not want to push this into production because this kind of doesn't look that great with all these different image sizings. But this is all just stock photos that I threw in here just to kind of get an idea. And you can see at the bottom of each one of these cards, read, study, PDF. If I click one of these, boom, opens a PDF to the study. So it's pretty cool out of the box here. And then if you do something like, can you show me the latest study? It should generate just a single card exactly like it did with this carousel. Usually this doesn't take as long. There we go, right? Boom. So we've got this single card here with the image. It's got a lot of stuff here in this description, which I would, you know, fine tune down to make it only a few sentences, because in a web chat, that's going to be a lot of scrolling for the user. But you'll notice what I like about this is there are three buttons at the bottom of this card: read the study, which we know opened up to the PDF, view all research, and then schedule demo. So if I click this, this will go to their booking page. So it's nice that all of this has been generated completely dynamically from the agent. You'll see if you look at this canvas here, there is no, outside of the initial greeting message with the 5-minute demo button, there are no buttons on the canvas. There are no cards. There are no carousels. I don't have to sit here and what was happening before you had to, you had to do one of two things. You had to toggle exit every conversational turn, and you had to kick out of this agent block into your normal, you know, whether it's a button, a card or whatnot, or you have a conversational path that's based on something like a call to action. Like somebody wants to schedule a demo. Okay, let me kick out of the agent node and do this. So what I like about this is this reduces some of the necessary routing on the canvas depending on the use case and the application. Now, okay, might say Connor, like, how did you get this to work? Now, let's see, I wanna do this again so we can kind of showcase. What was that question again? Oops. Can see my Claude popping up there, help giving me some assistance here. Google Studies by time period. And I absolutely use Claude to help me write this instruction. And it's based off of what Voiceflow is giving us in the JSON of this output, which I want to kind of show you here. So if you click on any of these, boom, okay, where is it? Choice with 5 options on the output. So this is going to show you what the payload looks like for each of these particular buttons. But if we look at, where is it here? Is it agent starting execution? Here it is, perfectly. So this kind of shows the agent starting its execution and all of the tools that are kind of available to it. So you'll see that knowledge base and that description, my modification of that LLM description is coming through here. So it also has buttons, which Voiceflow's display UI picker, card. It has all of these things that are in here. So we can use this. We know what the JSON is, that Voiceflow is anticipating / expecting / uses in order to generate these cards. So what we do is we bring them into the instructions to kind of help the agent generate the type of cards that we want to. So if we go and look at the agent instructions, got a bunch of just general stuff. You'll see I kind of have a line break. Where are we at? All right. Clinical studies, dynamic content generation instructions. And I actually go through each when to use this format. Here's the button. Here's the card. Here's the carousel. For the card, use it for a single study. And then content structure requirements. Here's what you do for the title. Here's what you do for the URLs. Here are the suggested image URLs, which once again, these are just stock photos and they're just general. Like I'm not actually attaching specific images to cards, But I could do that just by giving the agent the particular instructions. And then if we scroll down a little bit more, here's the button example. Here's the JSON. Here's a button. Here's the parameters, the different ones. Show me studies by time period. So like, yes, I'm stacking the deck by asking a question that I specifically, you know, told it how to handle in here. But for this demo and for trying to understand like how all of these web elements on the front end interact with Voiceflow and the agents, like I think it is useful for everybody to go through this particular workflow just so you get an idea of what's going on here. Card examples, boom. And then it's got everything. It's got the title, it's got the image URL, it's got the description. So I'm stacking all of this in the particular agent instruction in order for to get the behavior that I want. Now, if I was to actually like push this out and push this into production and get this working, I would probably not just take all of the stuff and shove it in to the agent, because this is going to get, you're going to start to potentially water down your agent instructions the more and more that you throw in here. So what I will probably end up testing next is having specific pull calls. It's like, okay, I want to make this dynamic button. I'm going to go get this particular structure. The first thing that kind of like jumps to mind for me for this dynamic carousel generation is something like in an e-commerce land where you've got product suggestions. It's like, okay, I'm going to execute a tool call and function. I'm going to go to my backend. I'm going to get my specific product info. I'm going to create you this dynamic card off of that, which all of these things have been, you've had the ability to do them in Voiceflow previously, but it was a lot more manual, like routing processes. And as more and more builds move towards this almost simplified canvas where we have this agent node handling so much inside of it, whether it's this singular agent node or even like handing off to sub agent nodes, this was important to integrate this ability between the buttons, the cards, and the carousels in the agent node. That way, like all of this stuff doesn't, we don't start to lose some of these useful features of the Voiceflow canvas and being able to control an actual conversation that an agent has with a customer, a user, internal team, like whatever the use case is for. So I think that this is a really, this was a good like step in this direction to be able to do some pretty cool things. Whew, that was a lot to get out. Okay. What is, so that is update number two. Update number one was, like I said, the logs. Definitely jump it. If you have not gotten in here and jumped in here, take a look. And for those that remember when you hit the start, there was this like horizontal bar that you had to click to get all your variables. This is now just kind of in a log like this. And this is actually like big fan of this. So super happy that this is here. Oh, and this search, I think the search bar is new. Oh man, I was about to ask for this. This is great. I love this. Okay. Number two, we talked about it. Dynamic buttons, cards, carousels. Make sure, I'm telling you, be as specific as you can, especially in the beginning. Like it's really cool to showcase, oh, I'm so dynamic. You can just randomly do all of this stuff. But for production builds that are out on the street that are actually interacting with other customers, like you need the consistency. You need the style done. You need to make sure that you are testing these things and getting them to act the way that you want to every single time. So put in the effort, write good instructions in your agents and test them into oblivion. Okay, number three, I'm actually going to pull up a different canvas here. It's a different account. So this was kind of flew under the radar here. Let's talk about functions and tool calls. So previously inside of agent nodes, you had the ability to call a function. Functions in Voiceflow have input variables and output variables. Now, in order to map an output variable from a function into a Voiceflow canvas, like general variable, what I was doing previously is I would in the paths, as it exited, I would load up all these required variables and say, LLM, you're going to execute this function and you're going to get these output variables. I need you to take the values of those output variables, and as you leave, I need you to map into all of these required variables. So what ended up happening was it would work most of the time. Now, most of the time needs to be underlined and bolded, because maybe like once every couple weeks, or, you know, once every couple days, depending on, you know, how much these agents were actually seeing live, I would have instances where the LLM was unable to take that structure of output variables and map it appropriately as it passed out. And it would just be zero, and other things would, you know, other functions would fail, it would break flows, and the agent would get confused. And I actually started making like helper functions where I would confirm that the output variables as I left had values. And if they didn't have values, like I'd go back to the agent and say, hey, you didn't get this. Like, go collect this again, just to kind of like as a catch-all. You don't need to do that anymore. So something that has changed, you'll notice that inside of these tool calls for functions, for input variables and output variables, you've always had the ability to have, you can force the input variables to be specific values, and in certain cases, other Voiceflow variables, which is super useful. For example, this is a zip code lookup. So this is a booking agent. It's trying to book a job. First thing it needs to do is make sure the customer's zip code is in the service area. Now, I don't know the customer's zip code yet. So you'll see agent collect is going to go, hey, it's going to ask that question to the customer, which is like, what is your zip code? Then it's going to take that in and it's going to map it against an array of all the zip codes that it has to make sure that they're in the service area. And then it immediately follows up that zip code lookup with another endpoint with a bunch of different information. Now, here's the new push. Here's the newness. Okay. For output variables, now if you'll click here, like I can directly save these output variables to a Voiceflow variable, okay, right as the function gets called. That way, I'm taking the LLM out of the equation and reducing the chance that the LLM makes a mistake based on seeing all of the data, which any time that I can take the LLM out and I can programmatically code the functionality that I want, I'm gonna do that every single time, because it's just going to make things way more consistent. And I love that I don't have to spend the instruction canvas resources, which I do believe is limited. I don't have to say, okay, you're going to get this output variable, map it to this thing, because Voiceflow now just allows you to directly do this right here in the canvas. So super happy with this particular update. And that's really it. So there's new stuff happening in the canvas. Like, I'm in here, I'm doing something. I'm like, what the heck? What is this new freaking logs? Like anything in the AI space, you know, we're moving fast and loose. But at the end of the day, all of these changes, I am confident will result in more consistent, better user experiences for customers interacting with agents. So if you're not out there building, what are you doing? Anyways, any questions, feel free to reach out. You know where to find me. Happy building out there. All right. See you later.